stylish leathers and sheepskins. It's only First Direct for the very best quality guaranteed. It's only First Direct that will give you the lowest prices guaranteed from only £19. It's only at First Direct pre-Christmas sale. So go to First Direct, Derby Street off Cheetham Hill Road, Manchester.
Strongbow. Nothing else quite hits the mark.
They'll never get me. I'm licensed. You know why? Because I got this fabulous Akai F10 video on option 3 at Mumlows. And they gave me 3 months worth of TV license stamps free.
Who captures Mama Nature's goodness to bring you the perfect spaghetti bolognese sauce? Dolmio do this, so all you have to do is eat and enjoy the perfect spaghetti bolognese. Dolmio, the best from Mama Nature.
Quick Save. Dedicated to saving you money.
Riding along an auto.
It's the story of the motorized carriage.
My baby beside me at the wheel.
The pleasure of passing a driving test.
I stole a kiss at the turn of a mile.
The fun of fantasizing.
My curiosity running wild.
The mania of driving.
Cruising and playing the radio.
It's Rowan Atkinson as you've never seen him before. The driven man, Rowan Atkinson and the motor car. Saturday at 10:20 on Granada. It's a transport of delights.
I was anxious to tell her the way I feel.
This is Granada, and now let's catch up with the latest events at Emmerdale.
You selling today, then?
Yes, Mr. Pollard, we're selling today.
And it's settling stock you're entering?
Yes.
Yeah, it's no crime, is it?
Nope, no crime at all. Just that you won't get much for it today, that's all.
How much can we expect?
£5.50 if you're lucky. Any reserve?
No reserve, Mr. Pollard. Just selling.
Any news? Oh, for heaven's sake, how much longer?
We should get the results today. They told us that.
When today?
Well, it depends on the workload at the lab.
Well, what about my workload? Those youths should have been in that field 2 days ago.
Soon make it up.
Oh, will we? You know, I was talking to MacArthur earlier on in the village. He said if those bones do turn out to be human, we might have to dig up the whole field.
Well, it'll save me having to finish my trench, then.
Oh, very funny, Sarah.
It's not very likely. We didn't dig up any clothes or stuff with the bones, so if they are human, they're probably quite ancient. Mind you, the archaeologists might want to investigate then.
Archaeologists? I see. So what you're telling me is that even if the police don't care, we still won't be able to get on with our digging.
If they are ancient, it could be very interesting, Jack.
Oh, very interesting. Much more exciting than digging boring old trenches and farming, not to mention earning a living. Well, if you'll excuse me, Sarah, I'll just go and see if there's some small part of the farm I can work on without interfering with the police inquiries or the archaeologists' excavations.
Yeah, it took me all day Sunday to make it. It's dead strong, you know, it lasts a lifetime.
Yeah.
Can't you be a bit more enthusiastic? I didn't make this for you.
Oh, look, I'm really sorry, Archie. It's really good. But you see, the thing is, I don't know what Elsa will say. She's been a bit fussy about things at the moment.
Ta-da! Can't you manage a smile either? This is a first Archie Brooks production crib. Handmade, free gratis, with compliments of the season.
You made this?
Yeah, with my own fair hands.
For us?
Yeah, thing is, well, I might have to borrow it for a few days before Christmas, because I've got a little deal going with Cura. After that, it's all yours. Isn't anybody going to thank me?
Look, the thing is, Archie...
It's lovely, Archie. Thank you.
Right. Thanks very much.
Well, let's hear it.
I don't think you're going to like it.
Oh, no. Don't tell me it was a murder victim.
Not quite.
An ancient Briton?
Well, the bones are quite old, apparently. About 100 years, they reckon.
Does this mean the archaeologists are going to descend on us, then?
No. Not really.
Well, for heaven's sake, Sarah, what were they?
A goat.
A goat? You mean we've had our work held up for 2 whole days because some farmer decided to bury his goat in our top field?
I knew you wouldn't like it.
Right, lot 46, suckling stock, property of Blackthorn Farm, and a good piece too, so I'm reliably informed by Mrs. Feldmann. Right, who's going to start me off with £600, £600 anywhere? At £600 anywhere, £600, £550 then. At £550 anywhere, £550 anywhere, who's going to start me off for £550? £500 then, £500, I'll take £500. £500 anyway, £500. £450 then, £450. £450 anyway, £450. £450 I have. At £450, £460 anyway, £460. Thank you. £470, £470. £480, £480, £480. £480, £490. £490, £500. At £500, £500. £510, £510, £510, £520. At £520 I have. At £520. Divided by £550. £550 anyway, £550. £520 I have. To you, sir. £520 it is. £520 it is. £520.
That was nice of you.
What?
What you said to Archie. I know it's not exactly what you want, but he was only trying to help.
I meant what I said, actually. I do think it's lovely. Once we've put some padding on the inside and maybe a little frieze running along the outside, it'll be perfect.
But I thought you said only the best for our baby. I mean, this, well, it's very good for Archie, but it's not exactly the best.
I know, but I've been a bit selfish, thoughtless and stupid, haven't I? So how's about you and me sitting down and trying to work things out properly?
You changed your tune a bit.
Yeah, well, maybe I just realised there's lots of people worse off than me.
Ah, Mrs. Feldmann. Sorry about that. I was hoping to make a bit more.
Not your fault, Mr. Pollard.
Well, it's as I said. Bad time to sell. Most people don't this time of the year. Unless they have to, of course.
Well, you know how it is, Mr. Pollard. Everyone needs a little extra at Christmas.
Oh, don't forget, things are still tough in the new year.
We didn't say things were tough. Come on, don't let today put you off.
We always try to do our best, especially if local farmers are contemplating a bigger auction, dispersal sale, for example.
As Michael said, things aren't that tough, Mr. Pollard.
Yes, well, I wouldn't have mentioned it, only I was talking to one of the reps in the feed merchants the other day. He reckons the farmers around here are going to have a very hard winter.
Now, that's your income there.
Not very much, is it?
And that's my income there.
Which we won't have after the baby's born.
I thought we were trying to be positive, Nick.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Right, now, I'm not going to get any maternity pay because we've already checked.
And there's no guarantee that Alan will take you back after the baby's born.
No, but I think he will. In fact, I was wondering if he'd take me on properly then. Well, think about it, Nick. That's my YT wages. But if I could persuade Mr. Turner he needs me full time, we could treble that.
But would he?
Well, he certainly needs someone.
Or would he just save money and take on another YT trainee?
Oh.
Look, even if you do go back to work, we've still got to find a childminder.
Yeah.
But then again, our outgoings are still pretty low.
It's a good job, isn't it?
Oh, come on. Now it's been negative.
Would you blame me? It's hopeless, isn't it?
Look, there's always ways around things.
Yeah? Do you know I got a leaflet from the hospital on my last visit? About antenatal classes. I should go to them. The way things are at the moment, we can't even afford the bus fare.
Ah. Well, that's the first problem solved, you see. Because you don't need to go into Skipdale anymore. There's this article in the local paper about this woman, this side of Hotton, who's running classes in her home. We could even go together. Like I said, there's always ways around things.
What now?
Nothing. I thought I'd come and see how you're doing.
Well, I haven't got time for a chat, sir. We've got work to do.
Well,
We'll soon make it up.
Not if we stand round yakking when I've got this work on.
All right, Jack. Point taken.
Well, come on, out of the way!
Well, hang on, Jack. There's something here.
What is it? Sarah, if you say it's more bones...
I'm sorry, Jack. I think you'd better come and have a look.
Sarah, we haven't got time for this.
What is it?
Well, come on, what the hell is it? Sarah Connolly, you are the most exasperating, infuriating, irritating woman that I have ever known. And so help me.
I wouldn't change you for the world.
Now give us a kiss.
Oh, this is from Auntie Claire.
Trust her to be first with the Christmas cards.
Wishes us peace for the festive season, a prosperous new year. That might be easier said than done.
Yes.
Still, at least we can afford someone to feed now, eh?
Yes.
Who's that from?
Frank Tate.
I don't suppose it's a Christmas card, is it?
It's this quarter's rent demand. Plus the arrears for the last quarter.
The fibre in Kellogg's Toppers helps keep me flying right. But it's the delicious topping that fires my youthful appetite.
Small problem. The shredded wheat nutrition gives me what I need. But the kid in me loves to tackle the tasty side.
Kellogg's Toppers. Shredded wheat nutrition for the adult in you. Delicious taste for that part of you that'll never grow up.
The fibre in Toppers fills that empty part. When it comes to the great taste, I'm just a kid at heart.
I'll have what she's having.
If you're struggling to make ends meet, you may have wondered how to get by without fuel this winter. You could try putting on weight in summer, gorging on fish, nuts and berries. You could wear a big thick coat, then put yourself to bed until spring. If that sounds inhuman, British Gas would be the first to agree. We don't want people to lose sleep worrying about gas bills. Rather than do without the bare necessities, ask about our gas payment plans. They make keeping warm a lot easier.
We're sure that you'll find we've Christmas in mind, with prices so festively pleasing. Tasty fresh chicken, 65 pence a pound. 2 litres of vanilla ice cream, 99 pence. 2 litres of Morrison's lemonade, 49 pence. With prices so jolly, you get more in your trolley. Merry Christmas, everybody!
I ain't missing you at all. Since you've been gone away.
Oh, Signor Dalva. Siéntese.
Gracias, gracias.
Share a love. Bit early, aren't you?
Actually, I was popping in to see if I could beg off tonight altogether. We're so far behind with the farming.
Oh, I should think so. Providing, of course, Mr. Wilkes sees fit to fulfil his barkeeping obligations.
Oh, why shouldn't he?
You can never tell these days. He's not said out to you, has he? Regarding his plans at Woolpack.
What plans?
You may well ask. He's plotted behind my back. Heaven knows what he has in mind, but he can't wait for me to retire.
Oh, Amos, you've got it all wrong. He's just concerned about you, about the Woolpack. Why don't the two of you just sit down and talk about it properly?
I suppose you're right, Sarah. I'm being a bit of an old fool, aren't I?
Just a bit. I'm sure you'll sort it out.
Must seem quite comic, really. It's such a big step for me. I mean, I want to retire, but I can't bear to leave work back. I can't bear to think of it changing after I've gone.
I'm sure Henry feels the same way, Amos.
I'm being a bit unfair, aren't I, taking it out on Mr. Wilkes?
Oh, he'll understand. Just talk about it properly. Now, I must rush. Where shall I leave these?
Where are they?
Well, they're new Christmas decorations. Henry asked me to get them.
What's wrong with our normal decorations, may I ask? We've been using them for years now. I can see no reason to change.
Well, they are a bit old and tatty, Amos.
No, they are not. There you are, you see. That's exactly what I mean. Mr. Wilkes is going behind my back. Planning alterations without a word of consultation.
You sound happier today.
Yeah?
Could hardly get a word out of you on Saturday, let alone a song.
Yeah, well, me and Elsa have finally had a chance to talk.
Oh, good. Well, I'm glad someone can manage to communicate properly.
Why? Are you not with Chris?
Oh, take no notice. I'm just being silly.
Yeah, well, from what I remember, you weren't too happy yourself on Saturday.
Oh, it's just a misunderstanding.
Really?
I got it wrong. Chris was working all the time.
Oh. Right, well, come on then.
What?
Well, it's my knocking off time, Kath. You can make me a coffee.
Oh, right.
And then it's my turn to listen to you.
Why?
Here.
I'm not hungry.
We have to eat, Michael.
But I'd rather talk.
We'll talk better with some food inside us.
Today's money won't even begin to cover the arrears, let alone this quarter's rent. We have to work out what we're going to do.
Did I ever tell you about the time your father and I first started on this farm?
What's that got to do with anything?
We had our first calf in winter. Snow everywhere. The calf was breached. Hopeless. Well, any other farmer would have let it go. But your father insisted we stay with it all night, trying and trying.
Well, good for him. That's exactly what we need to do.
But that's just the point, Michael. It was a waste of time. The calf was stillborn. Talk me then. Some situations are so hopeless, you just have to give them up.
So is that what you're saying? We just give up Blackthorn?
In the end, we might not have much choice.
Look, Kath, come on. If it was just a misunderstanding, he was at work. I don't understand why he's still so upset.
He's so unpredictable, I suppose. But then that's one of the things I like about him. It's just difficult to live with sometimes, that's all.
There's nothing wrong with having fun, you know. You're too serious sometimes.
I know, I take things seriously, Nick.
Look, you should just try and let yourself go, Kath. Do what Chris does. Have a few laughs now and again.
But you can't treat everything as a laugh.
Why not?
Because for a while, it's fine. It's fun. But you keep on doing it all the time, with everything. Then it makes you wonder just how much people care about things.
So you're wondering whether Chris does actually care?
Even on Saturday, he never stopped to think why I was so upset. It was just a big joke again, a laugh. Jackie left scars, Nick. I know that. And maybe it did make me take things too seriously. But it also taught me never to take anything for granted. And that's one lesson Chris just hasn't learnt yet.
Come on, Archie, see some goodwill.
So what else, Doc?
Archie, I've been looking all over the place for you.
Hiya, Tom.
But did Nick tell you I called in at Dambach earlier to see how you're getting on with the new crib?
Yeah, he did say something. Did he mention the deal?
What deal?
The thing is, Tom, I agreed to make Nick and Elsa one first.
That's all right. There's plenty of time before Christmas. You can easily knock another one up.
Knock one up? It's complicated to work her up day and night.
I thought you said it was a simple design.
It's deceptively simple. No, the thing is, Nick's agreed to rent his to you.
What for?
The church tableau, of course. He said when I was to see you, I was to get the money off you, like.
Oh, that's very nice of him. It's a shame, though.
Why is it a shame? The church needs a crib and you've got one. Everybody's happy.
Yeah, including my vicar.
What's your vicar got to do with it?
Well, you see, I persuaded him to part with £60 for a new crib. do. There's no need now.
Eh?
Well, I didn't seem right to ask you to do it for nothing. But if it's okay with Nick, and you're too busy.
No.
He's very, very busy, Tony.
Not really got a moment to spare, have you, Archie?
Okay. I'll see you later.
No, hang on. Look, it's a good cause, and 60 quid, you said.
That's right.
Well, I'm sure I could do something.
Fancy that. Amazing.
The yous are all settled in nicely.
Good.
What's up?
Amos and Henry. Honestly, Jack, they're just like a couple of kids.
Oh.
Amos is convinced that Henry has all sorts of dire plans for altering the wool pack, but he won't talk to him about it.
Oh, I should leave them to it, love. They've had plenty of practice.
No, it's really bad this time. They need someone to sit them both down and make them see some sense.
Well, if I were you, I'd stay well clear. Is that Robert's costume for the play?
No, it's the wise man's outfit. I've volunteered to lend a hand making the other costumes as well.
Farmer, barmaid, diplomat, and now theatrical dressmaker. Is there no end to your talents?
Oh, there's plenty more to come, Jack. You haven't seen the half of it yet.
Well, believe it. I'm actually in business.
We should celebrate.
Oh, hiya, Mike. Do you want a drink, mate?
No, it's all right. I'll get me one.
Nah, come on. We're celebrating. Archie Brooks Enterprises.
Look, I can't afford to buy a round.
Oh, let Archie buy Michael. He has just signed a major deal, his first step to becoming Beckendale's millionaire crib maker.
All right, then. Just start, thanks.
Hey, I tell you what, why don't we all go to Emmerdale? There's no one in tonight. Get some cans. Archie could buy some champagne to celebrate. And I'll be a lot more comfortable.
Yeah, why not, Archie?
I should say so. Let's go.
Right. It's really well made, Mum. See, no sharp edges, and the base is strong. Best of all, it's completely free.
Yes.
So, what do you think?
It looks very nice, and it is well made, I must admit.
Yeah, Archie worked really hard on it.
It's a bit low, though, isn't it? I mean, imagine bending down to lift a baby in and out several times a day. He'd put you back out in no time.
Well, we can always put some wood underneath it, I suppose.
Well, it's hardly practical, is it?
Mum.
Yes, well, beggars can't be choosers, can they?
Right then, chaps. How about a toast? Archie Brooks Enterprises.
Archie Brooks Enterprises and all who sail in her.
Mm. He could be on the brink of a fortune, Archie.
Oh, yeah. Especially if you start selling to them big shops.
All right. It's only a crib at Cure. No need to make such a fuss. Hey, Michael.
Hey. Oh, yeah, sure.
I'll tell you something, it's better than working here for next to no.
Mm. Is it okay if I help myself to a refill?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks.
What are we going to do tonight, then?
We're doing it, aren't we? We're having a drink and listening to some music.
Is that it? Does anybody fancy an orgy?
Orgy.
All right, well, it's trying to cheer you up. It's like a wake in here.
Don't talk to me about wakes. Ever since Jack found them bones on the top field, I've been having nightmares about bodies and things.
On top field? That's where the baby stone is, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, it gives me the creeps.
Baby stone?
Yeah, you know, the one in the corner. It looks like a woman holding a baby.
There's a farmhouse there before Emmerdale even. Don't you know the story? Right then. Light us off time.
We've already declined your invitation for an orgy, Archie.
No. I want to tell you a ghost story. The curse of Pender's Fell.
Oh, there you are, Amos. What a relief. Beginning to think you'd retired already. I have been in here on my own since 6 o'clock. Sarah couldn't come in this evening, she told you herself. For heaven's sake, you're behaving as though I don't exist.
On the contrary, Mr. Wilkes, it's you behaving as though I don't exist.
All I'm trying to do is to get you to tell me your plans.
My plans? You're one as is busy making plans, and if you cannot see fit to talk to me, Mr. Wilkes, then I see no reason why I should talk to you.
Years ago, right, where your top field is now, Rach, there was this small farmhouse, right? Yeah, anyway, none of the locals would have built on that land because they knew there was a curse on it. After a fire wiped out this entire family, they were all burnt to death. Anyway, this young couple didn't know about the curse, so they built a house right on top of the land. They lived there for 4 years, nothing happened at all, absolutely fine. Till then, one night, the husband went away. Woman, she was only 24 years old, laying in bed, just imagine it, laying in bed asleep, and she heard the cries of a baby. She got up, went to see a baby. baby was fast asleep. But she could still hear the cries. It seemed to be coming from outside. Anyway, she went out into the garden, crying louder and louder all the time. And all of a sudden, stopped. Nothing. Just silence. There was a dog howling in the distance. It was freezing cold and the wind blowing. She turned back towards her house and looked up and saw this weird woman in her bedroom with her baby in her arms, with a really strange smile on her face, just staring out. The woman, like, tried to run back towards her house. Like, the ground was disappearing beneath it. It was like she was running on air. She got nearer to the house. That vanished too. She was screaming and crying herself by now. She looked back to where the house had been, and all she could see was a stone. The shape of this woman from the window, the baby in her arms, turned to stone. It's a warning that nobody should ever build on Pender's Fell.
Some story. I don't think I'll ever dare walk past that stone again.
Oh, I don't believe it.
True, so I'm sitting here. You've heard it before, haven't you, Mick?
Yeah, yeah, I wouldn't build a house there.
You believe it?
What? You mean about a ghost farm on the Fell? There's nothing unusual about that, if you ask me. There'll be loads of them up there the way farming's going these days.
I don't think we're talking about the same kind of ghosts, actually, Michael.
Well, it sounds like the same to me. It's just a new version of an old story. Except this new one will be called The Curse of Frank Tay.
Now, hang on a minute. My father cares about local farming, Michael.
Oh, yeah. He certainly cares about making money out of it.
I don't think that's very fair.
Have his way. He turns us into museum exhibits and charge admission to see us. Frank takes make-believe land.
My father is trying to make the land around here pay, Michael, and there is nothing wrong with that.
By turning it into a playground? All area will be one giant bottling's next.
Well, it's better than letting it slide into a wasteland.
Next thing you know, he'll be taking the stock out of the fields and sticking wooden cows in the fields instead, like they do down south.
Rubbish.
Oh, just see the coach signs now. Roll up and see the starred attraction of the Feldmans in Wonderland.
Do you fancy a refill, Zoe? Yeah, sure.
Prat.
Oh, I wouldn't pay much attention to him if I were you. Joe was telling me they're having a really hard time up there.
Well, I'd gathered that much.
I don't think he means half of what he says.
Oh, you mean like the curse of Frank Tate?
I don't think he means any real offence.
No.
Most of the time he's really quite nice.
Nice? He's always been miserable whenever I've seen him.
He's good looking though. Especially when he gets all het up like that.
It's not Zoe's fault, you know.
No?
No, she can't help who she is, can she? It doesn't help you treating her like a televiony, you know. Even though her old man does do a pretty good impression. Look, this is supposed to be a celebration. You just ruin it by rowing. If you don't like her, just pretend.
Who says I don't like her? Tell you the truth, I quite fancy her. Especially when she loses her temper.
Sandra Burrow's single, Just This Side of Love, is now available from record stores.
Joanne McAndrew decided to have her nose altered. In a moment, This England follows her progress in the nose job.
That's Emma, my sister, with William. Emma may look like an angel, but she eats like a horse. Watch this. Chicken nibbles, prawn vol au vent, 3 sausage rolls, pavlova, triple chocolate gâteau, champagne sorbet. All that for you. For me. Thanks. Hey, Emma, it's a good job Mum's gone to Iceland.
We're asking these people who've already shaved this morning to try the revolutionary new Braun Flex Control.
Feels quite good, actually. It feels like it's cutting more off.
We wanted to see how the new pivoting head and twin foils followed the contours of his face for a really close shave.
I can tell where it cuts and where it doesn't need to cut anymore. Thanks, that feels good. Really good. Can I take it?
Then we checked what his other shaver had missed.
Feels good. I like it.
Once you try it, we think you'll agree you haven't shaved till you shave with a Braun.
Six assorted tarts. An organic pomegranate. Chocolate teddy. Tea strainer. Nuts. Sausages. Something else. Something else. Got the nuts. Got the chocolate teddy. Book of stamps.
You can now buy books of stamps at thousands of different places. Stick one on your shopping list.
Didn't she do well?
Akai's 51-centimetre flat-screen Fast-X remote-control television, £369. And this Akai LCD programmable remote-control video recorder, £299. Buy the two, and a CD MIDI hi-fi system is yours absolutely free. Yes, all for only £668, or only £18.36 per month, APR 25.9. See local press for details.
There's £1 off turkeys weighing 10 pounds or more at Iceland now. That's why Mum's gone to Iceland.
I've made such a fool of you. Well, both of us. Will you cancel the honeymoon and the co-op hall?
Yes, yes, in a moment. Look, will you be all right?
There isn't anything else to say, is there?
See you in the shop, Miss Nugent.
Business as usual.